This is Roosevelt Gist with AutoNetwork, and we're here in Seattle, Washington with Kia, and my guest is the new Vice President of Marketing, Ian Beavis. Yes. Thank you for taking the time.
You're most welcome.
You have, a big challenge to keep the Kia brand moving forward. How do you plan to do that?
Really, what we've got to do is really do a much better job of positioning the brand in the minds of consumers. We've done a pretty good job of seeding the idea that we have a great warranty and that we've got safety in the cars, but I think going forward, we really have to build a bigger story about the brand. I often describe it as sort of the Rodney Dangerfield of the car business. We don't get much respect, so we need to get more of it.
And if we look at your storyboard, what's that going to look like to accomplish that?
Well, you know, product is, you know, at least 30 points of IQ, and we've got some great products coming through. So at each launch that's coming through, Rio being the one you're seeing today, but Sedona, Optima, each one of those are sort of going to be used to leverage the brand a little bit further. For instance, we're going to emphasize functionality a great deal in Sedona. In Rio here, we're going to emphasize roominess and handling. So we'll continue to build attributes by model, but by using connective tissue in our campaigns, build a bigger Kia brand.
Now, obviously, you don't have the huge budget as some of the competition. How do you plan to do that and strategically?
We're smarter than them.
They will see this, you know.
It's fine. No, you don't have to outspend anybody. We have sufficient marketing resources to get the job done. What we've got to do is be more effective and efficient with what we do. You know, the media we choose, where we choose to do it, how we have continuity for our programs. We've had a wholesale rethink of that. Also, we're integrating PR and marketing and product planning to a greater degree than has been done the case. And I think you get more efficiency and consistency of message out of that.
Now, is this something that you bring to the table, or is it feedback from your dealer group, or is it from the board, or Peter? How did that all come about?
It's pretty much from everybody. We've got some very aggressive dealers who've done a great job for us, and they continue to grow. And the plan is, as we go forward, is not to increase the dealer count, it's to actually increase throughput through the dealers we currently have. So we've got a very good, you know, interaction with them, so we know where their heads are and what they're thinking. Peter's got a very clear vision of what he wants to do with the company in the last 4 years. You've seen what we've done with exclusivity, what we've done with product development. What Peter was looking for me to come on board was to try and unite the three disciplines that I just mentioned and really ratchet up our activities, and that's really what we're doing. There's a lot to do.
Now, have you picked a model to be the halo to bring the traffic to the showroom for the others to feed off of?
Our two core models at the moment are Sportage and Spectra, and both of those vehicles we want to get in the next 3 years to about 100,000 units each. And so they'll be, you know, they've been launched, and they'll have a continuity program and consistent marketing against them. Then we're going to use each of the launches that come in to take us one step further. Sedona will be very, very important to us. That's a very strong core product. And then Optima is a product that we've not marketed very much in the past, and so the plan is to really, really push in that. And there's a very good niche for that product. So it's just building blocks. This is not a complicated business. We just make it complicated.
I heard that from the previous interviewer.
Yeah, we don't have time to make it complicated, nor do we have enough people. So, it's very simple. It's making sure you basically leverage your product strengths with what the consumer's needs are and communicate them in the appropriate manner. So that's really what we're doing.
Now, obviously, we're here for the Rio and the Rio5. What are the strengths of the Rio and the Rio5 that you're going to show in your ad campaign?
Well, interior roominess is a huge strength of the product, but engine performance, it's, you know, superior engine power and, you know, better fuel economy, plus the dynamics of the vehicle. It's got very strong appeal to a younger audience and an older audience. It's very interesting. The median age is about 46 for the segment, yet there's sort of 50% of it is actually under 30, and then 50% of it is over 55. So I would say that we're going to market the car to people that are young at heart, irrespective of their age. So that's where we're going.
And I'm sure you, when you developed this car and the features, we didn't have the problem with high gas prices. So how is that going to help or hurt you?
Well, it helps. I think there's a couple of things that are going on. One is the segment is growing because there are more entrants, and frankly, we welcome it. We study the enemy, so we know what they're up to. So they're going to advertise and get people thinking more of the segment. And we've come in with a car that is really absolutely up to the minute and right for the time by increasing the horsepower, but increasing the economy. Every new engine that we're going to bring in as each successive generation of products here will have superior engine power and better fuel economy.
Now, is there one medium for advertising that's going to be better for you?
No. Television's still important. It creates awareness. It drives traffic into dealerships. You know, it gets a large audience. It's still a mass medium. But in the case of us as a brand, we've got pretty good awareness. What we need to build is familiarity and consideration and opinion. And to do that, you need to be multifaceted. So we'll be using television a lot, but we'll be target marketing with events. We'll be doing a lot more on the internet. We'll be doing a bit more with outdoor and a bit more with magazine.
Now, I noticed you showed us one of the two commercials that are coming out, and you told the ad agency, I guess, you didn't want a celebrity. Why was that?
It's about Kia. It's not about the celebrity. I don't want what I would refer to as video vampire situations where you've got someone really taking over. I've had to emphasize to everyone through the campaign that he is presenting our manifesto, and he is the instrument of it. He is not the campaign. So when you'll see him in television used in many different ways. You won't necessarily see him in print. Because it doesn't translate. You know, what I try and do is use the medium that we have at hand in the best possible way. So I don't do moving print ads on television. So I use the medium for what it's best for. You'll see a sales event campaign for him where we can actually use him in print to some degree and in a different way in television. So the beauty of the guy is he's just very flexible.
Now, obviously, he must have tested well.
Yes, he did. The brief was we wanted a cross between John Stewart and John F. Kennedy. So he sort of bridged that gap.
Now, once those commercials hit the airways, what will determine whether or not you made the right decision to keep this guy or are you going to pull him?
Well, it takes a time for these things to work. We've done research already. We know that there's a fairly high level of consumer acceptance. Got to sell cars. That's really the ultimate asset test, but I think if we can start to raise awareness and familiarity in some of the messaging, and we'll get reads on that in about the first 3 months, that'll give us a pretty good signal. The other thing is that the campaign doesn't depend necessarily on him. What he is an instrument, as I mentioned. He's also a way that we're trying to get some connective tissue to help build the brand. So there's a million different ways to do that. That's just one particular way. We may just, in some campaigns, just use him as a voiceover because he has quite a distinctive voice.
Now, obviously, you were again brought on board to move this product up the line. What are some of your immediate goals?
And the immediate goal is to really make the most of the launches. Launch cadence is an issue because we are at this. It's like working for NASA. This place is like Cape Canaveral. We've got so many launches, so it's making the most of each launch and using a launch to get us to the next level and then building on that. So Rio is important to us. It's a small volume vehicle relative to some of the others, but it's very important in giving us a spirited and young sort of profile. Sedona is really a mainstream minivan, a fully competitive mainstream minivan, which will improve functionality in every area, so we'll build on that. And then Optima is going to be more about dynamics and interior room, again, for its segment, consistent with where we're going with Rio.
Great. Ian, thanks for taking the time.
Pleasure. Anytime.
It's Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network, and we're here in Seattle with Kia. And as always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive. See you next time.